Hello and welcome to the Miraculous cast. We're going to be rewatching Miraculous Ladybug from the very, very beginning, sharing our thoughts, opinions, and things that make us laugh. I'm Hildaglitz. I play Chloe in the 86th Floor cosplay music videos.
I'm RascalRabbit and I play Adrian in Cat Noir.
I'm Luminara cosplay and I play Ladybug slash Marinette.
We're going to be starting our rewatch with The Bubbler.
This will include spoilers for all of Miraculous, so if you haven't seen the rest of it, what are you doing? Go and watch it.
And at the point that we're filming right now, season 3, episode 2 has just come out, so we don't know anything beyond that right now.
All right, shall we start watching?
Let's do it. I love how anime this opening is. Like, I don't know if anyone watched like Orin High School Host Club growing up, but like—
Absolutely not.
No, this is very like— No, and not the way like it pans up with all the characters. Yeah. Like, this is an anime.
Also, Marinette's like fully like— Yeah. Right now.
No, it is. I've always felt like when I first started watching this, I thought this is the most anime cartoon I've ever watched. And yeah, I don't really watch any anime, but it definitely
does
have anime vibes.
Even without the prior knowledge, you know.
I know. Well, you know those anime tropes, though.
Yeah.
There are anime tropes.
Yeah, lots of them.
Happy birthday, Adrian.
That's so cute. He's wrapped up a camembert for Adrian.
But like, he did it really good too. Like, how do you manage when you're this big?
No, he didn't. Look at what's going on. What's going on here?
It's the angle.
I feel like Pug didn't buy that cheese. It was in the fridge. Adrian bought that.
Yeah, but he made the effort to put the ribbon on it.
It's the thought
he's
that
trying.
Counts.
Okay.
Also, like, I really love camembert so much. Like, I relate to Plague on a spiritual level because camembert is the best cheese. And yes, it does smell, but it doesn't smell bad. Like, it smells fine.
Well, right? I have a problem with this because that's clearly just like a solid bit of camembert. That's come straight out of the fridge.
Yeah.
It doesn't smell until you like
until you bake cook it.
So why is it smelling so much?
And also,
maybe it's old.
Oh.
Flag.
Marinette, don't forget to clean your room after school today.
Mom, it's Friday and I'm already doing something with Alya.
Is Friday like a designated not clean your room day? I don't know about you, but I'm always out on the town.
Yeah, it's the day before the weekend.
Yeah.
It's basically the weekend.
Yeah, to be fair, like I think if my mum turned around and was like, you've got to spend your Friday evening cleaning your room, I'd be like, no, thank you. I'm going to go.
Right. Indication that Marinette's out on the town.
No, she's not out on the town, but she's out with friends.
Yeah,
like it's sleepover night or it's movie night.
Nothing to do.
You know, places to be, people to see, Alya to see.
Busy.
Adrian can't relate, so.
So we've established it's a Friday in this.
It's Friday in the universe.
It's Friday, gotta get down on Friday.
Please stop.
I'll go ahead and clean it, but don't blame me if I come across any of your private stuff, like your emails, your diary.
Okay, I'll do it.
That's not good parenting.
Was her mom threatening to read her diary?
That's...
And her emails.
That's not legal.
That's not good parenting.
What if you have letters addressed to you?
A bit invasive.
Your parent can't open them for you legally.
Really? Yeah.
No.
I don't know if that's the same in France. I don't know.
Anything goes in France.
Anything goes in France.
But here in the United Kingdom, you are not allowed to open mail addressed to what, somebody else or your child specifically?
Someone else. That belongs to them.
Okay.
Yeah, but emails, that's also bad.
It is bad.
That's not good parenting.
Respect your privacy.
Normally I love her, but this is a bit off the line.
No.
I think Sabine and Chloe wear the same lipstick. It's the bizarre shade of pink. Like, so when I cosplay Chloe, I actually wear a slightly different lipstick, mostly because that kind of really, really pale pink. Excuse me, hello? Sorry, technical difficulties, please bear with us. This is going in the video.
This is quite funny, actually.
On
Friday night.
She and Alya just in a room, turning a light on and off, like, woo! So I
used to wear the exact shade that Chloe wears, but it looks so horrible on a real human being that I just had to stop. And so now I wear this sort of very bright neon shade.
Isn't that pink beige? Is that the original one? Pink beige.
Yeah, it's the one I wore in the bowling video.
It's like very, very pale pink.
Yeah, it's almost just concealer. Like,
should not be on a lip.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Is this the moment to talk about my Sims universe theory?
Yeah, okay, go on.
Okay, so I have a theory about Ladybug. I think that it is set in the Sims universe. Like, you know, Sims, the computer games. It has to be, because there's never anyone in Paris, so it's kind of just a locked off map called Paris. Everyone kind of behaves like a Sim, and all of the architecture looks like it was built in The Sims.
I actually do support this theory.
Thank you.
There's no like objects around. It's just
everything. You know how in The Sims, like, well, in The Sims 4, I think you can move stuff around like diagonally, but for ages you weren't able to have stuff diagonally, so everything was just blocks. Yeah. And that's what it is.
It's The Sims universe.
Someone's got absolutely mad with this table, and it's too big for the room. And there's two men, like only three people live here. Does Natalie live with them?
I guess Natalie does live.
I think she does.
She's a living nanny.
Slash assistant.
Because Gabriel's not going to do anything for himself, so she kind of needs to be there all the time.
No, this is, they're not really entertaining at this house.
I mean, yeah, so why do they have like 12 chairs at this one
it's
table?
It's all the friends Adrian wishes he had.
Well, that's relevant for this episode.
Yeah.
But Adrian is sad the episode.
It is actually, he's very sad this episode. But everyone just keep in mind this Sims theory, because it does start to make a lot of sense.
Has your dad always been such a downer? You think he'd at least remember what it was like to be young and want to party a little?
The concept that Gabriel has ever been out to party is really foreign to me.
That's not nice.
I mean, he knows a lot of like wealthy people. Like, he's a socialite.
He
probably gets invited to some pretty fancy events. He probably goes on an iPad. He probably Skypes in.
Oh, he's here.
I know what you mean now, but I thought you meant he was just like sitting on his own in a corner.
No, he's just sitting there playing Candy Crush.
Wait, am I seeing what I think I'm seeing? Don't tell me it's Adrian's birthday.
I'm really shocked that Chloe doesn't know it's Adrian's birthday. Like, surely she would know that.
Well, no, because she just expects Sabrina to know.
You've got to know, you're right.
Am I wrong?
Now, I still feel I must do a disclaimer here, sitting here literally dressed as Chloe. I love Chloe a lot. I think she's a very interesting character, and they've done a lot of really cool things with her in season two. But in season one, she is pretty irredeemable.
She's bad.
But I just find her really, like, interesting. I think she's a good character, even if she's not a good person.
Ugh, do I have to do everything myself? Seriously, what are you good for?
This is not how you treat your friends, people. This is bullying. Don't do this. I don't think we have to say that, but like, I have to say that as the Chloe fan in the room. That's not how you treat your friends. We don't do that to our friends.
We don't condone this.
Did you get the gift I sent you?
No.
What? Oh, those delivery guys.
Because this is played off as, like, she's lying because she didn't get Adrian a gift and she's pretending the delivery guys were too late. But this is definitely something I've done. Like, no, but you know, when suddenly, you know, your friend turns up to school and it's their birthday, and you genuinely didn't know, and it's not that you forgot because you're a bad friend, it's because, like, how are you supposed to remember everyone in your class's birthdays? And everyone else has got them a present, and you're going, oh, it hasn't arrived yet. And then you have to go and buy them a present and bring it to them on Monday. No one else does this?
What I find interesting...
You're a terrible person.
...is that Adrian had to, like, be like, no, I didn't get it. But I'm like, you didn't get anything for your birthday.
Why did you have to think about that?
It's like, no,
Let me just scroll through all the zero presents I got for my birthday.
No, don't remember.
Gotta go. Photo shoot.
Photo shoot.
I hate being beautiful and famous.
Damn, I hate being so famous and beautiful.
This is proof that Adrian is a very sweet sunshine boy, because I don't know if this is the end of the day or if this is during the day.
We have no idea.
I haven't decided.
But if this is midday of school and he gets to leave halfway through to do a photo shoot and he's sad about it. He cares about his education.
He does care about his education. Well, no, I think also he cares about his social life, because
he has no friends. He was homeschooled
up until this point. And so he likes being at school because it means he gets to get out of the house. He doesn't have to sit on his own at that massive table. And he actually gets to socialize with people his own age. So I too would be sad if I had to leave to go to a photo shoot.
The more you think about it, the sadder his life gets.
Can we stop thinking about it, thanks?
Looks like I've got some business to take care of with Adrian's old man.
Who is he talking to? Nino just in the middle of the street like, I guess I've got to sell Adrian's old man. Also, who talks like that? Who said, do you ever go around to your friend's house and go, I'm gonna go talk to your old man, and then just leave? Like, what is that? Nino, explain.
When did he even get there?
Get where?
Just that area. He was over.
He just sort of wandered away, stood there and went, had a
little soliloquy.
This, if this was a musical, this would be the point where he'd have his like
his song.
Yeah, he'd go on a golf course and like run around and like hit the floor.
Oh no.
You can bet on it.
Oh.
Oh, I hope he likes it.
You signed the note, right? Girl, girl, girl.
Girl, girl, girl.
Can we talk about one mood, guys?
That's a very good screen cap.
These are both of my moods.
My last two brain cells.
Me and myself.
Who was that, Natalie?
A friend of Adrian's. She was delivering a gift for his birthday.
Did you remember to buy him a present from me?
Nobody in Adrian's life, apart from Marinette, has remembered to buy a present for him. This is tragic.
This is when he's quite young as well. This is when you typically get like a few presents.
Yeah.
You know, your parents, relatives, friends. No, not for Adrian.
Not for Adrian.
He'll be here in a minute.
Adrian's not home yet.
How did Nino gain access to the aggressive mansion?
That's cut. That section's cut.
No,
we
but
don't know.
Like, how did he? Because when Marinette turned up, like, I guess she didn't ask to go in.
It was a very persuasive hi.
Yeah.
Maybe he called her dude lots and said that things were chill and cool and then managed to get in.
Maybe
to the
she
mansion.
Just didn't understand his lingo and thought he like really needed help or something. Like,
small child.
Maybe it's an emergency. We'll see what we can
cool
do.
This cool surfer dude needs help. I've got to bring him into the mansion. Oh, no. I'm just surprised that there wasn't at least like a security check.
This is it.
There's a huge gate outside that mansion. I refuse to believe that Gabriel just lets anyone in. Unless he knows Nino.
I mean, he was going to kick him straight out. I feel like, what's the point?
Well, let's find out.
Photo shoots, fencing, Chinese, piano.
Nino, you're here.
Anything from my best bud. Show some awesomeness, dude. I mean, sir.
Any case that Nino had is dead because he used show some awesomeness, dude. Like, Gabriel Agreste is very far away from being, like, he's cool, but in a I am icy way.
He
like,
is
he's
not
cool.
Awesome.
He's not awesome.
No.
I don't think he even knows the meaning of the word.
No. I mean, I don't quite know what context Nino is meaning awesome in, as if it's surfer slang. It's interesting because this is like, in the French version, he is like talking in the youth dialect of Paris, but the English translation decided that Californian surfer slang is a good translation, so
yeah.
I decide what's best for my son. In fact, I've just decided you're a bad influence and you're not welcome in my house ever again.
So Nino manages to get into the mansion, say three sentences to Gabriel Agreste, and Gabriel Agreste
he's banned
goes,
for life.
He's banned
he's
for life.
He's expelled.
All right,
from
but spoilers. Gabriel is Hawk Moth, so he knows what he's doing. He's just giving this kid a hard time because he knows he can use that to his advantage. Like,
how do you know Gabriel is Hawk Moth?
What are you talking about?
What kind of accusation is this?
But a kid has walked in and he's like, I can use this.
And
he's
what?
Made him sad, potentially.
On purpose.
Yeah.
On purpose. So that when he walks out, he can be like, right, butterfly time.
Mm.
Let's turn you into a villain.
It is going to be really interesting, though, rewatching the series, knowing that Gabriel is definitely Hawk Moth. Because when I watched this the first time and we didn't know, it's kind of obvious.
You kind of go,
like, it was a really popular fan theory, and it did turn out to be true because it was very obvious.
There were a lot of fan theories that he wasn't Hawk Moth.
A lot of division about that. There were some people that were like, no, but like, he's Hawk Moth. And then a lot of people were like, are you kidding me?
Were you one of the people that didn't think he was Hawk Moth?
No, I thought he was from first episode.
Oh yeah, okay.
I mean, look at him.
Because I remember having discussions with you about this, and we were like, these are the reasons that we think these are the facts. This is what we know.
Facts. Here are the facts. He's Hawk Moth.
This is it.
Turns out, we were right.
Yeah, it's true. But it is going to be interesting seeing, like going forward through the rewatch, seeing if there's anything that we see differently.
Little hints
we know.
That we didn't pick up
little
on.
Hints.
Exactly.
Like that one.
Like this one, where this is potentially deliberate. Let's find out.
Father, he was just trying to do something cool for me.
Goodbye.
Why is everyone in this household so savage? Just
the most dramatic household. This is why he's Cat Noir. This is why Cat Noir is the way he is.
Well, because of this upbringing.
Because of this chaotic, like, dramatic upbringing.
It's true. Everyone's kind of operating like they're in, like, a dark gothic novel.
Literally.
Why does he blow bubbles?
It's his sad.
It's his cool identifying feature. Like, it's the thing that makes him stand out.
Well, I think
it's like when you pick up a weird hobby because you know that you can bring that to the table and be like, yeah, I do this. It's just bubble blowing.
It's an odd point, but like, I'm impressed with his breath control, being angry, and yet still able to like blow a steady stream of bubbles. Like, he's keeping his anger under control at this point.
At this
point.
Gentle.
It's not playtime, you've got your chores to do.
Adults ruin everything.
Just a quick note about that little kid. That kid was like 4 years old. What chores could he possibly be doing?
Empty the dishwasher.
Like, can you empty the dishwasher, please, my son who is four? 4-year-old son, you have to clean the windows now.
How frustrating. It won't be long before frustration.
Gabriel is like running around upstairs, like the door is closed and he's just gone.
Where's my mask?
No, so my towel on. So let's go through this beat by beat. Right, Nino leaves. Gabriel. He's gotta go. He's gotta get in his lift. Down the gate. He's spinning around, up into his jacket, quickly getting changed, and I'm ready.
No, but how does that work? Because I always assumed it was like an attic, right? It's like the windows like at the top of his house.
It is.
No, but he goes through it from the side room right on the ground floor.
So talking about his elevator is something we should probably do when we watch that episode, but we must quickly talk about his elevator. Because if you've seen the first episode of season two, he gets on an elevator and he goes down, but then he comes up into the attic. So I think there must be some sort of Willy Wonka glass elevator thing going on here, where he's on the elevator and he goes like down and then it like spins around.
It's like,
No, it could go down and then to the side and then up again, but that's not as interesting. It's funnier if he's like sliding around.
It just seems really inconvenient because to get to the attic, you have to go to the ground floor room.
Where the heat then goes down.
And then all the, I don't know, I feel a bit sick.
I also feel surely somebody would have noticed all of the butterflies coming out of the huge window in the biggest mansion house in Paris.
I mean, you think Adrian would have noticed? Is this like above his bedroom?
He can't see through the tears in his eyes.
Cheeky spots on!
Don't you wish this could be how easy it is to get into cosplay?
Oh no, literally. Is this not how it is to get into?
Yeah, anybody? Don't you do this?
Is that not how it works?
I don't want to talk about it.
No, okay.
Hey, birthday boy! Guess what? Daddy's gone. While the cat's away, the mice will play. Nino?
So he can recognize Nino, but not Marinette as Ladybug.
Adrian, sorry.
What were you gonna say?
I was gonna say Adrian has never encountered fun and instantly runs away in fear of the unknown.
That's better than what I was gonna say.
What were you gonna say?
I was gonna say that he saw their dance skill level and left.
Nino's is not good. He's just sort of like going like this.
I brought you here to party! So dance or else you'll join the adults.
Not to go on about my Sims universe theory, but you know when you throw a party in The Sims and all the Sims come around and they dance really awkwardly on their own? That's what's happening.
Nino's been akumatized. I've got to help him.
You may never get this chance again. Come on, let's have a little fun while your father's away.
So Flag's like, yeah, there's a supervillain here, but party though.
See, this is why Plague is so much better than Tiki in so many ways.
Tiki's too responsible.
Tiki would be like, no, Marinette, you have to go and fight the villain, you can't have a party.
Mm. Whereas Plague's like, do it, mate.
Plague's not a hater. But I like
Plague
this.
Plague just does not care.
Because this is the first, like, I don't even know if he makes a selfish decision in this entire show except for this, but it's because he wants to have a fun party with his friends.
I'm requesting a slow dance.
It's a bit early for that, isn't it?
It's for Adrian, his first slow dance.
Listen, I am a Chloe apologist, but she's a mess.
No, but why is Nino here supportive of this Chloe-Adrian dynamic?
He's evil.
Oh, because he's evil.
Yeah, because yeah, it's not a good dynamic, and so therefore, as soon as you are akumatized, you ship all the wrong things.
That's it, I get
that
get
makes
it.
A lot of sense,
yeah.
Actually.
Yeah, thanks for clearing that one up.
I love how matter of fact that is. Everyone's just standing there going, well. I just love how everyone looks like they're at a funeral. Like, it's not even like they're just awkwardly dancing. They're all sort of like leaning on each other like somebody has died.
But it's like, well, I mean, their parents are all in the sky.
That's true.
That's why they're sad. But it's like, they never communicate this to Adrian. Adrian just thinks they're having a horrible time at his birthday party.
He doesn't know what, like, he can't differentiate those sad and fearful from bored because he doesn't socialize enough.
No, he's not adjusted to society.
A record?
So, like, you know her lucky charm power? You know, when she, like, looks at things? I've always thought that would make a really cool mechanic for a video game.
Yeah, like, you have to like know which things to put together.
Because when I first watched this, I was like, I want to play a Ladybug video game where the whole point is like every level you've got to defeat an Akuma. And like that would be a really fun thing to do where you're given like an object and you do have to just work out what you have to do with it because it's never obvious to her.
I like that. Can we also talk about like Ladybug using her lucky charm to solve a petty issue? Because me too.
Yeah, that's not like... Tiki has a go at her for it afterwards, to be fair, but it does mean...
Spoilers.
Oh, sorry.
For 10 seconds time,
sorry. But I mean, she could use it for any problem. I mean, why shouldn't she use it more often?
Because she's not supposed to. With great power comes great responsibility.
I also like that she uses... That was really threatening. I like that she also like uses her lucky charm to like fix the bad music choice, because that is also something I would do.
I mean...
Well, I want to see this. That definitely would have shattered. She just threw that against like a marble wall, like a record.
But the marble wall was part of the thing. Like it flashed, so she has to use it.
It seems a bit extra,
doesn't
it?
It's a magic record. Like...
Spots off.
She just transformed in the middle of the street. Like,
yeah,
but because
there are no adults around.
There are no adults around, and also, as we know, nobody lives in Paris apart from these people.
You know what happens once you use your lucky charm. You only have minutes before...
I turn back, I know, but I figured the bubbler, he's not going anywhere.
To be fair, Cat Noir hasn't bothered to show up yet, so in her mind, she's there like, well, he really isn't going anywhere because he's DJing his sick mix. So, you know.
He hijacked his mix.
I like how this is the opening episode if you're watching from Netflix, and in that first episode, they introduce them as just not caring at all that, like, the adults are on their way to death.
Yeah.
They just want to fix their own issues.
Convenient that the only food at this party was what Tiki happens to eat.
Who catered for this party? There's just
Tiki did.
Tiki catered.
There's just four plates full of like just chocolate chip cookies.
Wait, no, hang on a minute. The Ladybug picnic CMV that as of filming this is not yet up on YouTube, but it will be soon. I asked you two to provide a picnic as props because I had enough to organise. And we got there on the day, and you brought this lovely picnic hamper and a blanket to put on the floor and some plates. And I said, "What food have you got?" And you, Luminara, just produced a baguette and one packet of biscuits, and that was it. And I was like, "What kind of picnic is this?" And you were like, it's a French one?
Well, come with me, I've got something for you.
There's something I have to do first.
It's about Adrian.
Can we talk about one icon of a wingman Alia is? Her parents have been abducted by bubbles.
and yet she's still committed to the cause.
That's her to get my man.
That's you know, a very good quality in a friend.
That's true friendship.
You know, the world's imploding. You know, like I was saying earlier, where, you know, the world's imploding around you, and still the most important thing is getting that man.
Sorry, Bubbler, but the party's over.
Why you gotta be like that?
The best line in the whole episode. Why you gotta be like that?
It's just, I love this. Absolutely me if I was a supervillain. Like, the authorities come and they're like, no, right, stop. And they're just, no, why you gotta be like that? He's just so mildly inconvenient. It's just.
It's so true, like, he's not even really trying to take over the world. Well, okay, no, he is actually. Like, he's sending all the adults into the atmosphere. But yeah, he just doesn't, why it gotta be like that?
He's like more upset that she just like turned the music off rather than
Yeah, I mean, I would be that upset if someone had, I would be more upset if someone turned my music off.
Those were some excellent superhero landings. We recently shot a Cells at Work video, which, as of filming this, is not up on the channel, but it might be soon, maybe.
Little plug.
But I had to do a superhero landing, and like, it looks really easy. You think, oh yeah, that's fine.
It's not.
It's not easy at all.
It's gotta be hard on
your
knees.
It's so uncomfortable on your
foot. It's really hard on your knees. I couldn't walk properly for 2 days afterwards because I do zero exercise.
My exercise is the Ladybug video. Can we talk for a bit about how I kind of feel, I feel bad for Nino, because like, of all the Akumas, he's got like probably the least selfish intentions.
Yeah.
He just wants his friend to have a fun time, and then Ladybug just shows up.
Help
and,
out.
Yeah. Why's she gotta be like that?
She gotta be like that.
Give me your miraculouses.
Give me your miraculouses.
Know what? Since you care about these adults so much, why don't you go flirt with them for a while?
Imagine Nino's parents finding out that he has been akumatized into this adult-hating supervillain, but it wasn't about them.
No, it wasn't
about... It was about his mate's dad.
So all parents
and
are bad.
And his parents are like, We're not so bad. We don't know a lot about Nino's parents. I don't think we've ever seen them. No, we've never seen them.
They're in the sky.
But it's not like Nino's constantly going on about how terrible his home life is. But no, it might be. Yeah. He might just be too cool to talk about it.
He's too cool. He's too worried about his bullying.
We can't stay stuck in this bubble together forever.
He's so terrible. Like, they're literally in a life and death situation. He's like, yeah, but.
What do you have to say about this?
Yeah, spokesperson, local spokesperson.
I'd like to apologize for all the opinions expressed by Cat Noir in this episode are not indicative of me. I'd like to apologize for his behavior. I'm sorry.
Me too.
Is that acceptable?
That is acceptable.
Do you know what's not acceptable?
This.
No one wants to party with you anymore, Bubbler.
What's wrong with all you guys? Why you gotta be such haters?
That is the best line.
Another iconic line from the Bubbler. Why you gotta be such haters?
You can't run forever, Ladybug. And when I catch you, I will crush you. I will destroy you both!
That attic looks huge.
It's huge.
It is a mansion.
It's a big house. You know,
surely somebody would have noticed. Do you think he got planning permission for his evil lair? He sort of wrote to the Paris Council and was like, excuse me, I'm planning on making a big attic for purposes that I'm not going to stage.
Butterfly garden.
Maybe he got funding for it.
But you'd think Adrian would know, because if his bedroom was like below, or in the same building, there's gonna be like a butterfly problem. There's like infestation.
There was a great, I remember the summer that Pokemon Go came out, which
was like a couple years ago, there was a great comic,
which I will track down and link below because it's very, very good. But somebody made a comic of
Adrian
playing Pokemon Go and walking around his mansion, and then he's so like into the game that he's walking along, and then he opens the door, and then like Hawk Moth is like there in his lair, like, and Adrian just goes, oh, I thought there was a Pikachu in here. Leaves. It was a really good comic. But then later,
that's so in character.
Hawk Moth's English voice actor said that, like, canonically said, Adrian is not allowed to play Pokemon Go. When I say canonically, that's just something the voice actor has said, but I buy
canon,
it.
Canon, yeah.
I buy it. He would not be allowed.
There were no adults yesterday to deliver it. So what? Ridiculous. Utterly ridiculous.
Ridiculous. Utterly ridiculous.
Hey, girls.
Hey, girls.
No.
That's what I said to you two earlier.
Hey, girls.
We were trying to go somewhere, and like there was a van sort of like turning out, and I without thinking, I turned over my shoulder and went, "Be careful, girls."
Madame Bustier move. From?
No, this is you being Madame Bustier.
Oh yeah, because I also play Madame Bustier.
Madame Bustier.
Like when I say I play Madame Bustier, I played her once because we needed a teacher, and I sort of vaguely had kind of what she wears. So it's not a very good.
It was the best Madame Bustier.
And people in the comments were like really into it. They were like Madame Bustier, good job, get it, girl.
I did enjoy being Madame Bustier.
Yo, nice scarf, Adrian. Off the chain.
What does off the chain mean?
I don't think I've ever described a scarf as off the chain. I don't, you can probably describe many things as off the chain, but a scarf is not one of them.
No.
Yeah, can you believe my dad got this for me? It's so awesome. He's given me the same lame pen for 3 years in a row.
So do you think when he says the same lame pen, is Gabriel so bad of a father that he sneaks into his room, retrieves the pen he got him last year, wraps it up, and then goes, Adrian, here, I got you a new pen.
And he's like, wow, gee, Dad, that's so good. My last one just went missing.
You gotta tell him you're the one who knitted the scarf. But he seems so happy about his dad. I don't want to spoil it for him.
Marinette is too sweet for her own good.
She's so pure.
At this sometimes.
Point, at this point in the series, in episode one, she's got a decent start.
Sorry.
Wow, rude.
We love Marinette, but also...
She's trying her best.
She is trying her best.
It's just upsetting.
And I love her. This is her best. She's making Adrian feel like he's loved by his dad. That's such a good end image. It's so anime, you know, like we were saying at the beginning.
Yeah, no, it's very anime.
She's sort of doing like the, you know, like the Virgin Mary.
So that was season one, episode one. We really enjoyed watching it, and we hope you enjoyed watching it with us.
We had loads of questions in the viewing of that episode. So if you can answer any of them, just like leave them in the comments below, please.
We can't wait to do more of these. We're gonna carry on with the series, but if there's any particular episodes that you want us to react to, then leave them in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more content such as this. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey you, the star I'm wishing on. Light up my world when things are wrong. Wanna tell you, but I trip over my words. I'm falling hard, is love supposed to hurt? I try to get home.
Yeah, it's fine.